Hey, my name is Lucas, and today I want to show you how you can run the open source version of N8N in the cloud. So your workflows can run 24/7 and you can access N8N from wherever you are and on whatever device you are over the internet. So N8N is a workflow automation software. If you haven't heard of it before, it's basically like Zapier or Make, but it's fully open source, which means we can grab the code and run it ourselves wherever we are and pay little money for that. So a lot of times these open source software like N8N, for example, they will be published on Docker Hub. So if we go to hub.docker.com and in the search bar, I will look for N8N. And right here at the top, we will find the official Docker Hub image for N8N. So let's head over to Sliplane.io. And Sliplane is a cloud provider that is specialized on hosting these Dockerized applications. So I will log in with my GitHub account and then I create a new project and name this one N8N. I will click on the project and click on deploy service. And first of all, I have to create a new server where the application will be running on. If you first sign up, you will get a free demo server that you can use to play around with. But keep in mind that these demo servers, they will be deleted after 2 days. So if you do like the platform, you need to attach a payment method in order to keep the demo server alive. So let's click on create server. I can choose a location for the server. There's 7 different locations. For example, let's choose Helsinki and a server type. But usually for N8N, the base type is plenty enough to run the application. And you can run some very complex workflows on this server without running into any issues. So let's just leave the default server and I will give it a name and call this one. Or let's call it N8N actually. Then I click on create paid server and I will be charged €9 per month. But if I cancel after a few days, I will only get charged for the days this server has been running. And let's click on create server. And after a few seconds, the server will be created and it shows up in the list right here. So let's click on the server. And if we scroll down a little bit, there is already an N8N preset. So all we have to do in order to deploy N8N is click on the preset and we are basically ready to roll. So right here at the top, you will find this docker.io/n8nio/n8n URL. And this one basically points to the image that is published on Docker Hub. So Sliplane will pull this image and deploy it on the server that we just created. And I will just leave the default settings right here. If you do need a different configuration, you can specify, for example, different environment variables. You can create a different volume where you store your persistent data. But I will just leave all of these defaults right here and I just click on deploy, as this is the fastest way in order to get N8N running. And after a few seconds, the deploy is in progress. And if we click on the application, you can see all of the settings that we just specified. And in the logs tab at the top, we can see what is going on this server. And since it is deploying right now, you can see all of these log messages that tell you what's going on, and the deploy will basically only take a few seconds to complete. So let's quickly wait until it is finished. The deploy is live and we are hooked up with this domain over here. And if I click on it, you can see I will be redirected to an instance of N8N that is now running on my server. This application will be running 24/7 and will execute my workflows. So I can quickly create a test user in order to see if everything is working. And there we go. We are inside our N8N application and we can create a new workflow to start automating stuff. So let's quickly head back to Sliplane, and I will show you how you can update the N8N instance. So down here at this registry config section, we can see the image URL is pointing to the latest tag. And latest means Sliplane will be pulling the latest image that has been published on Docker Hub. And if we click on redeploy, it will go over to Docker Hub and see if there's a newer image available. And if so, it will download the newest image for N8N. And you could also specify a specific version for N8N. So if we delete the latest tag right here, you can see there are tons of different versions right here. There is 1.9.0.2, 1.9.0.1, and so on and so forth. So you can just pick a version right here and click save in order to deploy this specific version of N8N. And if you do want to upgrade it at some point, you will just change this version tag right here, click on save, and N8N will be deploying in the background. In the events tab, we can see what is going on. So we just deployed, then we created another deploy, and the deployment has been canceled, then there's another deploy. In the volumes tab, you will find an overview over your volumes, and a volume in Sliplane is basically the place where persistent data will be stored. So whenever you head into your N8N application, you click on save, the information will be stored inside of this volume, and Sliplane will create daily backups of this volume. But since we just created it, there is no backup of the volume yet, but if we wait for a day, there will be a new backup right here. And you can also create manual backups if you, for example, need to do some important stuff and you want to be absolutely sure that nothing will break, you can create a manual backup right here. In the domains tab, you can see this domain that I just showed you right here, where you can access your N8N instance, and you can even create a custom domain, my N8N or whatever your custom domain is, in order to access your service via that domain. All right, if we don't need the service anymore, I can simply delete it right here. And after a few seconds, it will be deleted. But keep in mind that your volumes, they will not be deleted if you delete the server. So your data won't get lost immediately. And if you want to get rid of everything, you can also delete this volume right here. So that's basically all you need to know in order to quickly spin up your own little instance of N8N in the cloud and have it available 24/7. And if you did like this video, give it a thumbs up, comment, like, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.